Three mathematicians from Georgia Tech just solved a 40-year-old math mystery. Here they are, Yan and Jingjing at the whiteboard are going to help us understand it in an oversimplified way, and Dawei at the green board is going to help us with some easy basic concepts. Okay, this part will be a little complicated, but things are going to get simple later on. Their big accomplishment was to develop proof for this statement in graph theory, the Kelmans-Seymour conjecture. It says, if a graph, G, is 5 connected and non-planar, then it contains a TK5. That there on the whiteboard is an example of a 5 connected non-planar graph, and later on we'll see a TK5 inside it. But for now, let's uncomplicate. First, what are graphs, and what are they not? They're not shapes like, say, rectangles or circles, and they're not what people usually think of when they hear the word graphs. Instead, they're points, called vertices, connected by stringy lines called edges. And those lines don't even need to be straight, just connected to the points. Graphs that can be drawn in any kind of way so that those stringy lines do not cross each other are called planar. Sometimes that's easy, sometimes it's more complicated. See? Look, like this one. It looks kind of non-planar, but actually it is planar. Graphs where some lines can't help but cross each other are called non-planar. That takes us back to those TK5s. Yep, that part. TK5s are special non-planar graphs. If they're inside a larger graph, they're sure to make it non-planar too. So locating them is important. TK5s can be huge and messy, but luckily they're all related to what's called a K5. And it has a clear depiction, a 5-point star inside a pentagon. Real easy to spot. So back to the conjecture and the whiteboard. Yan and Jingjing are revealing for us, inside our graph, a small TK5 and the related K5. And for you math whizzes, yes, they're having to bend some rules for the camera. By the way, this is not how our mathematicians found their proof for the Kelmans-Seymour conjecture. That covers, about 120 pages of mathematical reasoning. Ben Brumfield for Georgia Tech Research News.